Welcome back to another episode of Woolly TV, and this one is episode 30. We made it to 30. And today, thanks to the guys over at Onboard and our rep over here, Ant-Man, we've got the Channel Islands Happy Every Day. Now this board sits between the Two Happy and the Rocket Wide. So I've done the Rocket Wide and I found the Rocket Wide was amazing in really small stuff in the step down range. Went great for me. I really liked it. I haven't ever ridden the Two Happy yet, but I'm sure I'll have a go on that at some point. This one to me, I've got a 6.0 at 34.2, which is right smack bang on what I usually ride around for my, you know, standard everyday driver. What it seems like straight away when you pick it up, it's similar sort of outline to the Rocket Wide, a bit more stretched out obviously because it's longer, and it's also got a bit more pinch rails on it, so it's not as blocky in the rail. It's got a bit more concave and it's also definitely got a lot more rocker in it too. I expect this one to surf a lot better in the pocket than the Rocket Wide did, but that's the type of board it is. So I reckon it's going to go good in waist height to overhead. So let's get this one out there and give it a crack. See you soon.
Try to hold you with all my might, but time has won, and I could never be that strong.
Don't cry.
I couldn't be that strong.
Don't cry.
That used to be my favorite song.
Don't cry.
She's so bittersweet.
Don't cry.
Through my eyes never would be. It's always
surprise this one was. This board went really, really well. It's right in the middle of that, you know, all day, everyday driver. I guess that's why they call it happy every day. I got to ride it in some overhead surf, which I normally wouldn't take a board out like this, but the swell jumped up on the day and it was 2 foot when I paddled out and 5 foot when I came in. So I got it, you'll see there's some proper overhead surf on it. I surfed it at a couple of the beach breaks around head high to overhead. I surfed it at my local little left-hand reef break where I do a lot of the board reviews. And I can say this board was exceptional. It surfed so well. It's held up really well. It's what I thought. It sits right between the Rocket Wide as a good little step down and then below the Happy. So the Happy, as I said before, I haven't ridden, but this one here worked amazing in waist high right through to overhead. I found I did use a bunch of different fins on it. I tried the Andos in the black sticks when it was small, trying to generate speed. They're a large fin. I tried the rakes in the, like a rake in the Legacy series in a mediums, but I found just the normal neutral Legacy mediums tend to be a perfect one for me. That's what I tend to ride a lot of that fin, and it worked really well on this board. As I mentioned before, the rail's a lot more pinched than the Rocket Wide, and there's more rocker, and also a bit more pulled in the tail, and it's got more concave in it, which allows the board to really fit in the pocket of the wave and surf up and overhead. So lucky I got this one and took it away on two different trips up north, and I got to try it in a lot of variety of wave. The only thing I probably didn't do a lot of was surf it down in really small stuff. But anything from waist high to overhead, this board was an absolute cranker and thumbs up, as good as any of the sort of daily drivers that I've ridden so far. So if you're interested in finding something that's just a go-to all day every board, it's a beauty. The 6.0 for me was perfect. That volume was perfect, didn't feel too big. The 34.2 was great. It's a touch wider than normally I ride in that length board. It's 20 and a quarter, but that wasn't a problem, didn't hinder it at all when the surf got a little bigger or I needed to get in the pocket. The board fitted in there really, really nicely, which is a lot different to the Rocket Wide. The Rocket Wide down here and below, unreal, but once it got in the pocket, it was a bit harder to fit it in there due to the lower rocker and the wider template. So this board, I reckon you could ride it, a good surfer could ride it as an all day, every day sort of board, a daily driver as they call them. But if you wanted to step it up and you're just looking for a high volume board too, you know, you could go to a 6162 and get that up into the 36, 37 liters. So guys that are a bit bigger could also use it as a normal all day, every day board. Thanks for watching. Got plenty of reviews coming through. I'm halfway through a bunch of them. Again, I'm injured. Done my knee again, different knee, my ribs. But keep on watching. We'll punch them out as soon as I'm back in the water. Thanks again. Don't forget to subscribe.